So students, in question 1A, we have to find the perimeter of this calculator using the shortcut method. So shortcut method means the formula which we have discussed in the last video lecture, okay? So here you can see this calculator is in the shape of a rectangle whose length is 90 centimeter and breadth is 30 centimeter. So we will use the formula, that is perimeter of rectangle is equal to 2 into length plus breadth, okay? So let us find it. So here is the answer for this question. Length is given and breadth is also given. So perimeter of the calculator, we can write 2 into bracket length plus breadth. So I have written L in place of length and B in place of breadth. So we'll put the values and we will solve it. We will get 240 centimeter. So students, please keep one thing in mind that here we have to solve the bracket first. That means the value in the bracket should be added and it is multiplied with 2. The next question is number E. Here you can see there is a window and the window is in the shape of a rectangle having length 90 centimeter and breadth 70 centimeter. So in this case also we can easily find the perimeter of a rectangle using the shortcut, that is the formula. Perimeter is equal to 2 into length plus breadth. Okay, so let us find it. So here is the answer for this question. You can find the perimeter of the window using this formula, 2 into L plus B. So in place of L, 90, and in place of B, I am writing 60. So 90 plus 60 is 150. So multiplying 150 with 2 will get 300. Okay, most importantly students, you must write the units, that is here it is centimeter, so don't forget to write the unit. Next you can see this is a square shaped rice bag and you can see the length and breadth. As you know that square is having all sides same or equal, okay? So that means the sides here all are equal. So the sides are 60 centimeter. So now we have to find the perimeter of a square using the formula which we have already discussed. So in the given formula, perimeter of square, that is 4 into length of side, just you have to put the length of the side, that is 60, and 4 is multiplied with 60, we will get 240 centimeter. So student, please try to do the remaining question from number 1. Let us do the next question, that is number 2. Question number 2, you can see students here, the side of square is given. Okay, there are different sides you can see in number A, B, C, D and all. You can see there are different sides of a square are given. That means the square is different from each other. The sides are different, therefore the square is different in sizes. Okay. So that means the boundary, that is the perimeter, okay, the perimeter will also be different. So see in number A is already done for you. The side is given 3 centimeter and you have to find the perimeter of this square. So you know that the formula of perimeter of square is 4 into length of the side. So here we have to multiply 4 with 3. So see, we are getting what? We are getting 12. Okay. Similarly, in number B, you can see the side is given 5 centimeter. That means we have to multiply it with 4. So we'll get 20. Okay. Similarly, in C number, we have to multiply 11 centimeter with 4 to get the perimeter. That will be 44 centimeter. So like this, students, please try to do the remaining questions. Okay. So you have to do this question in book itself. Just use your rough copy for multiplication and write here. Question number 3 also, you have to find the perimeter, but here rectangle is given. That means length and breadth should be given. So see, in number A, length is given 2 cm and breadth is 3 cm. So just add the length and breadth, you will get 2 plus 3, that will be 5. It is already written here, see. 2 plus 3 is equal to 5, and just multiply the 5 with 2, you will get the answer, that is 10. So see, the perimeter is 10 centimeter. So similarly, let us do B number. In B number also, you have to add 2 and 4, okay? By adding 2 and 4, you will get 6, and 6 you have to multiply with 2, you will get the answer, that will be 12 centimeter. So like this, students, just try to do the remaining ones, okay? So use your rough copy to do the calculation and write in the book itself. So in the last question of this exercise, perimeter is given and we need to find the side of the square. So already we know that if side is given, then we can easily find the perimeter by multiplying the side with 4, you will get the answer, that is the perimeter of the square. So here you can see the perimeter. What we mean by perimeter exactly? Perimeter is the total length of the boundary, and the boundary, we have to see that the boundary is the boundary of a square, and in a square all the four sides are equal. So here you can use the concept of fraction. In A number, perimeter is given 28 centimeter. So you can see here, this is a square having all four sides are equal. So that means we have to divide the total perimeter by 4. That will be, each side is equal to a 28 divided by 4. In fraction, we can write 28 by 4, and the answer will be 7 centimeter. So in B number also, you have to do the same. That is, perimeter is given 40 centimeter, so you can find each side of the square by dividing 40 by 4, and the answer will be 10 centimeter. So student, please try to do the remaining questions. If there is any difficulty, any doubt, you can ask me. Okay, students, so thank you.